Transfiguration. And the disciples asked him, "Why then do the scribes say that Elijah must come first?" He replied, "Elijah is indeed coming and will restore all things. But I tell you that Elijah has already come, and they did not recognize him. But they did to him whatever they pleased. So also the Son of Man is about to suffer at their hands." Then the disciples understood that he was speaking to them about John the Baptist.
The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In college, I had a very good math teacher. He'd explain principles in such a way until everyone understood what he was talking about. After explaining a theory, he'd ask if everyone got the point. Once he senses that there are doubts in the minds of the students, he'd say, "Forget about it," and explain the formulas in a different way. You see, good teachers are like that. They make sure their students understood everything and will not leave anyone hanging with some unanswered queries. I've tried to emulate those kind of teaching habits. That's why when I give a seminar or a teaching, I always pause in between paragraphs and ask my listeners if they are following. In today's Holy Gospel, Jesus explains who the present Elijah was to his disciples. Actually, a lot of passages in the Bible are difficult to understand. You'd have to be a theologist or a Bible scholar to know almost everything. For us lay people, it's simple. We ask the priest, the learned, to explain things to us. Then we continue to study scripture and pray for discernment and understanding. Then we nurture whatever gifts the Holy Spirit gives us. As you reflect on these, please join me in a short prayer. My mysterious and beautiful Lord, you have revealed to us the deepest and most profound mysteries of life through your written word. May I always approach your word with humility and openness so that I will come to know you more fully. Jesus, I trust in you. Amen. Good morning, everybody. It's a brand new day. It's a Saturday, the end of the week, the 10th of December, exactly 15 days to go to Christmas. Wow. The Christmas rush is still there, so please avoid large crowds, keep your social distancing, wear the mask, follow safe protocol. Okay, please subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and share so that some other people will know a short prayer or two. And of course, have a reflection, especially about our gospel. Okay, thank you very much in advance. You all take care. Have a good day, and God bless.